Balog wild and brutally attacked by Hulk Hogan. That's part one of a two-part interview,
yeah.
One-on-one, the Booty Man.
It was moving, pretty moving, I'm telling you.
It really was.
Yeah, and another one of them shock things that has happened here at WCW. You talk about a huge man, this guy is.
Ron Studd, who trained under the late Big John Studd, and now is taking his name and in the ring and using it. He's one of the biggest in our sport, no doubt. But, you know, a few moments ago, we heard from Arn Anderson, Ric Flair, and Lex Luger, and they pretty much let us know they are going to have a fourth man. Luger very upset, very distraught, but
yeah.
Flair and Arn Anderson are borderline irate right now.
Yeah, and they got somewhere you can have so much excitement about something and can overplay this thing. You've got to get a cool head. A leadership head needs to come into play here with all these seer heads that we got looking at this situation.
As a matter of way, we understanding, we have spotted the New World Order outside.
Uh-oh.
And we have dispatched a cameraman outside.
Right here.
To follow them. They are outside of the arena right now as we speak.
Wow.
And I have no idea what's going on. Can we go to the camera outside yet or not? Ron Studd and Lex Luger are set to go, but this warrants us to leave this match.
Yeah, Tony, I'm getting it too. Wow.
And to go outside is Lex Luger, obviously a little down as he makes his way to the ring, a little upset as expected, gets set to go in this one-on-one
match.
You're
kidding.
Here they come. All right, let's go. Look, it's the Giant. It's Hall and Nash. There's no Hogan. There's no Sting. There's DiBiase.
People are scurrying too. DiBiase got a camera in his hand here.
They are out near our video equipment. You see the box. What is going on? Let's listen in here.
Yes.
It's Luger about that.
Now look.
I think it's.
Now who is this, Tony?
Where are they pointing
to? One black caddy.
I think it's him.
Thanks, man.
Come on. Yeah. They're walking away from the arena door, fan.
Come on. You want to see something funny? Come on.
Uh-oh. They're out in the parking lot right here.
We brought our own camera, but as long as you're here, take a look at this.
Make sure it's the right one. Make sure it's the right one.
They're breaking into that car, telling me what they're doing.
Make sure it's the right one. Whose car is that? It's a Cadillac. Listen.
Is that his? Oh, look, this protein drinks in there. That's his.
Yeah.
Serious? It's Luger.
Luger's car. Oh, my goodness.
Hey,
the Giant and Hall. They're destroying this car. Luger's car. Parked outside near the video production truck.
The Giant is on top of the car.
The vandalism at work again.
Heavy damage here. Wow, how much more can we stand here at WCW? Hey, look at this place.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is some serious.
I got it all. Now that.
Wow.
This is a piece of art.
This is the NWO
damage wave
in
there, Luger.
And it's horrible.
Hey, Luger, don't mess with our limo, Luger.
Man, they talking about don't mess with the limo.
Yeah, that's
payback. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Payback.
The yellow spray paint in the limousine.
And Luger has not a clue what has happened here. Down from the situation with Sting, we don't blame him. What an emotional roller coaster the NWO has put on WCW.
Luger, as you said, dream unaware what has happened to his car. Little payback, as you heard. Don't mess with our limousine. When WCW attempted to spray paint that limousine with the yellow spray paint in the rain. And Big Ron Studd taking the measure of Lex Luger.
Yes.
You know, you talked about the emotional roller coaster.
Yeah.
Luger is an emotional mess right
yeah,
now.
Yeah. And the plans of the NWO surely have really turned the forces, if you will, in the tides of battle and facing. The war game's not knowing who is going to be where, and even tonight this attack, these guys are still around here. Security is beefed up, but NWO seems to, Tony, do.
One, two.
Wow,
Luger almost lost it there.
He needs to get his head in this game. He needs to get his head in this game. The NWO seems to do and move exactly what they want. There seems to be no problem with them doing what they want to do. This has to be stopped if WCW is to survive as a unit, as a company, as a team. Man, this thing emotionally just about got me drained. The car damage ain't the deal. You know what I mean? It's the way it was done and the emotion and the story behind it.
It's obvious, and this is certainly very redundant and after the fact, but they are here more than just to win wrestling matches. They are here to destroy people's careers, their own personal property. You know, I can tell you right now, we can have some legal ramifications. They can be arrested for what they've done, and they should be, and we've got it on tape.
Yeah, but Tony, we've got them all on tape doing stuff. The arrest and throw that out the window. Let's go on with it. We arresting them is true. Fighting them and winning is the answer, my friend. They have to be beat.
Up Luger, can he get the big guy?
Wow.
In the racket, he
unbelievable.
Did. He's got big run, stud.
Wow.
In the racket, it's over.
I have never seen him pick up that size of man and wreck him. Luger needs to get in the ball game now, baby.
Well,
maybe that got him going.
Yes, sir. They gave him a shot right in the arm. You can see it.
Yeah, but he's got to walk outside now and see the cow. See, so, I mean, that's the myth that we in.
Yeah, and who's going to tell him, huh? Yeah. Who's going to tell Lex Luger, hey,
but you ain't going to let him just walk out there. Doug Dillinger, what would he need to come and face him for?
Well, fans,
I mean, just walk out with your bag.
We will follow this story, and we'll be back with more on Saturday night after this.